Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Tom Mizzy. You watch my channel, Mizzy 14, and I'm here doing a review of Love and Hip Hop Miami, Season 3, Episode 6. Alright, let's jump right into it. Alright, so it started from last week. You know, that whole big old ratchet little fight they had last week with Suki Hana, Hood Brad, and Nicki Datru, all fighting and getting Nicki getting jumped and everything, which I don't like that jumping thing. But Nicki Datru, you gotta come in with your mouth. Girl, you doing way too much. So after they got Nicki Natchez all over the place, over there, away from the girls, Trina said she wanna go talk to Nicki and see what's going on. What was the issue? What's the deal? So Trina try to go over there, try to be calmly talk to Nicki. Nicki is getting aggravated. Trying to talk about that. The girls trying to jump me. You better go talk to them. Why are you coming over here and talk to me? All that stuff. And then she said, oh, hi, and Trini said, what's going on? Calm down. I'm going to talk to you. And called Trina a B. And I was like, oh, no. What you not going to do, disrespect Trina? What you not going to do, Nicki, disrespect Trina? I know you hype because you got jumped. But Trina did not jump you. Joy did not jump you. They didn't even know what happened. They came out here to see what the hell was going on. So you want to be all pissed off. You need to be pissed off with Suki Hana. You need to be pissed off with Hood Brat. Not with Trina and Joy, because they did not know what's going on. So they didn't jump you. Those two girls jump you. And now you're going to call Trina. Trina said, you ain't going to disrespect me because I will whoop your behind right now. So Joy heard that. Everybody said, what's going on? They all going. And they all were trying to get at Nicki. To the point that Nicki here got freaking snatched up by Suki Hana. I said, well, we taking wigs now. We're going to be another shade going on. So Suki took freaking Nicki natural hair and put it on her hair. I said, what are you wearing her hair for? You don't care for the chick, but you wearing her wig. But I care her weave, whatever you was wearing. So I was wearing it. She said, oh, Suki, pussy ass. Oh, I was like, oh, my God. So then Suki got on Instagram and doing Instagram posts about Nicki. I was like, oh, with the wig. And then finally, the committee was recording it. Suki threw the freaking weaves in the damn pool. I said, you need to stop throwing stuff in the pool now. Throw the pocketbook in the pool. Because she wanted her stuff. She said, get my stuff. That was that. And then Trina's in there. She called somebody and just going off on the phone. And said, what the hell is going on? This is ridiculous. All that stuff. He said, you got to do what you got to handle. She said, oh, I'm going to handle that. She don't know. I'm going to beat up. He said, don't know, mess with me. All that stuff. I said, oh, you got to hear that hot. Trina hot. So Trina is saying, you know what? I'm done with this. It will be no more boot camp. It will be no tour. I am so done because I gave these girls the opportunity and they all screwed it up. Yeah, that's true. They did screw it up. I was like, man, y'all cannot sit down for another second. First of all, it was wrong to be bringing Nicki Natural back. She has a problem. I don't know what this girl's issue is, but it should have brought her back. If they didn't bring her back, most likely they would be in the tour right now because they didn't need Nicki Natural in the first place. I said, first of all, what happened to that other girl? It was Nicki Natural battling in the freaking thing. What was her name? J Diva? What happened to her? Is she supposed to be part of the freaking tour? I guess she was just part of the dishes because I would say I could have sworn Trina liked her too. So why is she not part of the tour? But that was it. So they all disbanded. Briscoe missed his family. He says he's a changed man. He missed 3.5 years of his kid's life because he went to prison. He did some messed up things. He was selfish. Now he a changed man. He wants his family back. He wants his love and his life Cello back. They've been together for 12 years. And right before I think he got out, or while he went in jail, she broke up with him. And she moved on. She moved on with Mike Maya. So she kept going, and he won his family back. So they sat down. It's cool. Cello's a beautiful girl. Woman. And they start talking, and he said, yeah, I know I messed up her stuff. And basically, she's saying, listen, they probably hope for you, but I need to figure out what's going on with this. I need to figure out if I trust you enough to be with you again. I need to find out when you not gonna cheat on me again. I need to know that you not gonna go run the streets again. So she gave him hope that it will be a possibility they've been getting back together. That's all he needed because he started little smile in the end. He said, oh, there's hope. I said, oh, Briscoe, he's a handsome guy. So I said, okay, but you just messed up. And you can't always expect that a woman gonna be around all the time because she had years with you, and you feel like you the love of your life, and you just realize that she'd been there, and you messed up, and you dogged that out when you was out here, and you was doing your thing, and didn't care about her, but now you a changed man. And she said, you just got out. He said, yeah, but I don't have no attention running the streets again. I don't have attention to cheat on you. I have none of this. So I said, okay, let's go. That's the hope. That's all you need to go by and see if you do what you gotta do to make sure she get back in your corner. But if not, you just gotta move on and just be there for your kids. All right. Now I don't know if both of the kids is by her. I think it's one of the child is with her and it's somebody else.
Okay.
MJ, Shane, Amara. Basically, Amara and Shay made up. They made up. It was a petty, ridiculous reason why they had hold the grudge for so long, especially on Shay's part. Shay's so pissed off because Amara didn't tell her that Jody would be there, and Shay took it overboard because it wasn't even her vent. She should have just let it bygone, let it just know JoJo, don't care about JoJo, don't give JoJo the energy. You was there for Amara, it was Amara's vent, it was Amara's shine, and you took it away from her. They both apologized. They missed each other. They cool. They good. Amara told Shay that she got rid of Julian and she got to work on her career and do things for herself. And Shay gave encouragement where she said, you got this. You got this going on. We got your back. I know you're going to do it. You're going to be a great artist and everything. More power to you. Strive. And we're going to be there. So that was that. So Amara got a little concert. She had a concert that be sponsored by Boost Mobile. I said, I got Boost Mobile, hey. She got sponsored by Boost Mobile, and she doing her own concert, not Julian. Now she got to do things herself, make her own decisions, take charge of her life again. That's what she's supposed to be doing. So she met with Trina and just told Trina everything, and told Trina that she got this concert, she working hard, and Trina, she proud of her, that you need to do, you got to strive. I know it's hard to work, start all over, we got to find a new manager, you got to find the right team, but you have to do what you got to do for your career, and I'm happy that you are doing what you have to do. And she said letting go Julian as your manager was probably the best decision for you to do. She said that confessionals. But she said that was the best decision, and she's glad that Amara was taking a stand and owning up her own career and taking ownership and taking control of her own career. And I said that. And that was nice. And Trina said she had before her, and she just got to do what she got to do. So let's move on from that. All right, so Amara, while she's on this making amends and doing what she got to do and take it back, it's one little thing that's hanging in her mind that she's to hash out. And here comes JoJo. I said, oh, JoJo, okay. I said, oh, you just made up with Shay. Just, oh my gosh, okay, whatever. Met with JoJo. And she said she handled the thing wrong when last time she came to her. She had every intention to make amends, whatever, but she handled it wrong. And she just liked to let things be. She missed the friendship, what they had, and we could be cool, but as I'm getting cool with you, I don't want to mess things up with Shay. So it would be good if you and Shay could sit down and have an agreement. I was like, I was thinking that was not a good idea for them two to get together. They is on done deal. So she said, Shay don't really like me right now, and she's willing to come and talk to me, then I'm cool. But until then, if we not, then we not. It is what it is. And she just, but Amara is so worried that Shay go flip out again because she talked to JoJo again. I said, you gotta be so worried, and that's not your sister then. It is what it is. You shouldn't be that worried. It is good. She could get over it. And she have a freaking, if she have an attitude about it, let her have an attitude. Shoot, you were MJ, you're not schooling her. So that was that. With JoJo and Mama, but JoJo said if she want to talk to me, we gonna talk to me. But other than that, ain't no forcing it, and that's the deal with those two. But Amara did mention MJ, and JoJo said I want to say it out there before everybody's on the table, so you get upset. I met MJ in the past. He talked to me in the past. He tried to say numbers, but nothing happened from there. Nothing went further. She said, okay, I'm glad you told me. I'm not gonna get upset about that because it was way before me. So, it is what it is. I got more things to worry about. I don't worry about this little thing you have with your past. So, glad you told me, and it's fine. I said, good. That's a mature woman would take. I said, good, girl. It was way before me. I don't know you then. Maybe. I don't know. But I didn't know him then, It is what it is now. He's my man now. It's in the past. As long as nothing happened, nothing happened. Good. Alright, so Hood Brat was playing around with her niece and nephew. And her boyfriend Kenny came. And she told him what happened to boot camp. And he said, I understand why Trina's doing that. She just lost her mother. She went through a lot of things right now. And this is going on. Y'all messing up. Y'all fighting. And so I'd be frustrated too. So what you have to do, you need to control your anger. You need to control who you are. Because at the end of the day, they is not responsible for your actions. You are. So you should have moved yourself. She said, hey, I got the anger. And so it just came out of me. And she poking me and prodding me and stuff. I said, you walk there to try and jump the girls. So I don't know about anger and prodding you have so much. But she said she wanted to talk to Trina. Well, Kenny said, you need to sit down and talk to her and see if she could at least do the tour. Because he was like, all right, so in the boot camp is direct relation, correlation to the tour. So that means once the boot camp is done, the tour is done, or the boot camp could be savage, but you can still do the tour and you just got to work someone out. Check it out. Work things out for the tour and say you got to make arrangements. So she'll go sit down and talk to Trina. So she met up with Trina. And Trina says she's not here for it. She don't know. She's not here for it. She can't deal with this. She can't deal with your girl. She can't deal with the antics. She built this boot camp. She wasted her resources and money and stuff to build this together to make sure y'all be ready. And y'all effed it up, basically. So Trina said, no, not right now. I can't. I got too much thing going on right now to even worry about this little girl's tour because y'all do too much and y'all destroy that. So her brother said, oh, that's it. I said anything else you can say. Prima Donna, it is what it is. Prima Donna did her little rap section of video where she was doing, basically rapping about Jocelyn Hernandez. This is her and everything, talking cocaine and saying everything, president, Puerto Rican president. You need to say something else, girl, because you're saying the same thing every week and it's getting retired. We understand, she said she's going to war, and the best thing to go to war to have soldiers to give you ammunition against the person. So she got reached out to Dawn. Trick came and she was talking to Trick. Reached out to Dawn, she told me some stuff and found out that joke is nothing. She not in a come up. Right now, she's still broke. So I'm not stupid down to her level. I can't be in her little level, so I'm going to do what I have to do, and not even fall for that. I said, girl, act like you is the one big shot in the show that people knew who you are, and that you were so above and beyond approach, above and beyond this little pettiness, that we should congratulate you for not even going down to Jocelyn level. I said, it wasn't that much. Whatever. Whatever, Prima Donna. You said you want to take the high road, you take the high road. It is what it is. All right, so the last thing. No, two things. Suki, Hood Brat, Chameleon, and Saucy Santana. You know, he's the rapper in Miami. He's a rapper. But it's what it is. Y'all know, he's a gay rapper. It doesn't matter. He's a rapper. And Suki messed with us. She messed with Saucy Santana. She said she cool, she rocks with him because he shouted me out in a video. We be go way back. We cool. I got respect for him. He got respect for me. We good. So she went there. Chameleon was there. Chameleon had a chameleon in her arm. I said, all right. Hood Brat came with her lime green orange hair. I said, oh, you look like a color rainbow girl. Every time you see, which is a different color. What's going on? Different color. All right, so they talk, and Finn Hood Brat told them and said, listen, I sat down with Trina, and she is not doing the tour at all. So Tuka said, what the F you mean? She not doing the mother F a tour. And Chameleon said, right. She said, she just done. That fight y'all had, because Suki said, you know, because Duke Natural. She the one who come in and fighting everybody and dissing everyone and cause this fight. Well, I would say, listen, it take all of y'all to mess this up. I mean, except for Chameleon. Chameleon wasn't involved. But I think later on she died when they started getting up and they got disrespected Trina, and then she got up and see what's going on. But y'all all was responsible. It wasn't just Nicki Natural. Y'all all were responsible of getting this day tour messed up. Y'all couldn't calm down and just ignored each other or whatever you had to do, but I hear that. So Saucy said, you know what? It would have been great to have Trina back and name on your thing, but at the same time, you can't let her stop your bag. So what y'all should do, y'all should come together and do your own tour. And work together doing your own tour. So it shows people, y'all have connections. It shows people that y'all serious, and it shows that you could do something yourself. So it would have been nice to add Trina, but it's not the end of the world. Do it. And put your own concert together. And so they all contemplating that. I said, cool, cool. The last thing of the show was Trick getting arrested. He got arrested in charge of DUI and possession of cocaine. And I said, oh, we saw that on social media played out. So Joy got it. She called Briscoe, told Briscoe about it. Bobby got the thing, text. Freaking Trina got the text. Everybody in the mother started getting the text about Trina. Not Trina, about Trick and his drug charge possession. Oh, drug possession and DUI. I said, oh, Trick, that's not good. And then he was trying to get his life together, too. So to have this charge pending like this, I said, oh, snap. But that was Love and Hip Hop Miami, y'all. It wasn't that much. I mean, it was the aftermath of everything that had going on. It was maybe a chill episode. So it wasn't that much beef and drama and ratchetness. But please like, comment, subscribe to my channel and tell me how y'all feel about this review. And tell me how y'all feel. If y'all saw the episode, how do y'all feel? Put that in the comment section. And we'll talk later, alright? Peace.